One. Hey, real quick, I want to announce the winners of the drill competition. So, in third place was, so congratulations. Now, I was kind of looking at the unit leader. Matuin McMill had experience at, Colorado, right? So, some of you guys might think that's a little unfair, but also Matuin Zilmer was leading the platoon beforehand before he got injured, so we had to make a quick swap. It makes sense, so just live with it. But taking the unit leaders out, all right, I still want to congratulate first platoon. You have the best overall platoon score, so good job on that. So those are the results. Well, I'm posting, put them on the honor platoon spreadsheet.
Quick word to pass. They're playing football, see Mitchell and Lamp after this. If you're missing lab at all next semester, or you need chits to be late, those chits are due by CUB tomorrow. We do not have lab next Tuesday, but we have lab next Thursday. And that is currently in khakis. Next Tuesday, we are not in khakis. Mentor mentee is due CUB tomorrow. Any questions?
Don't make me come track you down for mentor mentee time. It won't be fun. Same thing with chits.
Hey, if you haven't finished paper out, that's due by COB Monday. So
hey,
make sure
out,
you do that.
Time out quick. Midshipman Lamp, what's your position next semester?
I think so, sir.
Okay, so when Midshipman Lamp says, hey, to make sure this is all in on time, and like three people, we went through this last week. We are not having a repeat of last week's lab this week. When the new XO says, get this done, there should be a collective chorus of voices right now saying,
aye, sir.
All right, say it again, Mr. Lamb, so they all hear you.
Make sure you get mentor-mentee time done by COB tomorrow and your chits in by COB tomorrow if you need to be late or need to miss lab. I don't want to complain.
Stand by.
Get your nose dead.
Is that understood?
Yes, sir.
Smells awful.
Hey,
in the back,
is that
fan on
tonight?
Put it up,
sir.
Sir,
still
smell
that bad? Oh, yeah.
A lot of it's PT here
for
this morning.
We're
ready?
Yes, sir.
A couple outstandings, a few goods.
And.
Oh, wow. Are we ready?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir.
All
right.
Driving safety.
Just like that. That's all I got.
All right. Texting and driving. So pretty soon you won't have to worry about texting and driving. And why is that?
It's going to become illegal, sir.
No.
Hands-free devices, sir.
Hands-free devices. No such thing.
Voice to text.
And all of you use that, right? Jackie, what do you use?
Cars will drive themselves.
Yes, that's the right answer. He must be in my class. So cars will drive themselves, right? First generation's coming soon. Tesla?
That was a grenade. You win.
Or lose. So,
yeah, same life. Fell in a meter.
So, illegal in most states, right? So texting while driving, don't do it. Major distractions, you have all kinds of them. Have you ever driven with a guy or gal sitting beside you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Bad idea.
Yes, sir.
Right? So, as you know, that distractions cause accidents. I'll give you some quick statistics about the 660,000 drivers attempting to use their cell phones while behind the wheels every day. The National Safety Council reports that cell phones
are a distraction, sir.
Okay. I'm so glad you're around.
Just for visual purposes.
Your next video is not right.
You see what I mean? Right? Isn't that annoying?
Yes, sir.
So don't do it in your cars. Okay. Lieutenant Burchill. All right, nearly 3,300 injuries occur every year from accidents caused by texting while driving. One out of four car accidents right now are caused by texting. One out of four. Unbelievable, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, texting while driving, six times more likely to cause an accident if you were just driving. Answering a text takes away your attention for about 5 seconds while traveling at 55. How long do you think that is? How far do you think you drive in that period of time?
Sir, about 200 yards.
Yeah, they say 100 yards, but I bet it's further than that.
Absolutely.
Some of the length of a football field. Texting while driving causes a 400% increase in time spent with eyes off the road. Of all things that cause accidents, texting is by far the most dangerous activity. 94% of drivers support a ban on texting, although 35% still do it. And then there's the whole teen drivers, the cell phone statistics, which is just pathetic. 11 teens per day die while texting. 11 per day. Anyone here a teen?
Yes.
That's you. 11 per day die while texting. How do they know you're dying while texting?
Sir, normally if you get in an accident or you end up doing anything while you're texting, they can look through your text messages and they see just like a bunch of blur going on.
Absolutely. They see that, they see the time, the date stamp. So they know if you're texting while you're driving. 11 per day, dead. All right. Any questions on that? Any questions? Texting while driving, Ben?
Yes, sir.
Got it. All right, distractions on your cars now that your radio, it turns off so you can't drive it, so you do all things like buckle up, make sure you do it, additional passengers, bad idea as described. Food! I'm definitely one of those that likes to eat while driving. So, do your best to not do that. If you do, it's actually best you pull over, eat, and get back on the road. All right. One other thing about driving, pre-flighting, and not the kind of pre-flighting you do before football games. The type of pre-flight I'm talking about is your car. Like right now, I've got a daughter that drives, so every time she gets, you'll see her do this lap around the car. So why do you think she's doing the lap around the car?
Check the tires.
Pre-flight, right? Check the tires, check the muffler, check for vandalism, check the moron that left the cart in the Sam's Club parking lot that ended up my BMW. All right? You gotta look for those things every time you get in the car. Driving duration for not longer than how?
2 hours, sir.
Who follows that rule?
Yeah,
right.
Nobody.
No, you should. 2 hours. Try to time it. Try to take a break. You know, whatever's required for that break. I was driving around in Germany, and my car, which was so awesome, it had the sensors built into it that shoots lasers into your eye, which supposedly is bad, but they do it. It senses your eyeballs. It saw me doing this, and it put this picture of a coffee mug on my screen and said, you need to pull over and take a break. I was like, that's brilliant. Why don't we have that in America?
It's expensive, sir.
It's expensive. I'm driving around in a 335 twin turbo in Germany, and I better not say the speed limit I was driving. All right, every trip well rested. Not after school on Friday, right?
Yes, sir.
Driving during daylight hours, extremely important. Nothing good ever happens past
midnight.
Yes! Awesome. Schedule break every 2 hours. Do not drink and drive. And pull over if you get tired. All right, horseplay. What's horseplay? Schedule, what's horseplay?
Horseplay is doing stuff that's
for the perfect action.
Like playing Ultimate Frisbee with the Chipmunk Lamp, right?
Is it cars, sir?
Oh, horseplay. Horseplay, right? Horseplay. Gets people in trouble all the time. Don't do it at home or on vacation. Injuries in the Navy. what one thing that you do in the Navy is most likely to get you injured?
PT, sir.
That's PT. Playing flag football with the Army?
Yes, sir.
I don't know, could be. When's that? Sunday?
Yes, sir. 1400? Yes, sir.
Be safe. Stretch before you work out, right?
Yes, sir.
Number one injury in the Navy, basketball. Way higher than every other thing on the list. Way higher, believe it or not. Basketball. Then soccer, then baseball, then weightlifting, then bicycling. In that order. Like far and above motorcycle accidents, car accidents. It's basketball. So, Dondo, you have me out there with your 3-point J. Be extremely careful, okay? Well, 40-year-old guys, 25 pounds overweight, 50, and they're out there. And you see this? Where are they playing on? Non-skin, right?
Yes, sir.
Why do you think it's a foot injury? Yeah. All right, we're supposed to be quick. So, water sports and motorcycles. Water sports. What's a PDF? Fill it out the computer. And it's like, I got to put all these sets. No, what is it? What's a PDF? Louder.
Personal flotation.
Louder.
Personal flotation device.
Excellent. All right, Officer Candidate Huff, I see you back here. Have you been introduced yet?
Not formally, sir.
All right, stand up.
Got it.
All right, in the back, this is Officer Candidate Huff. Welcome aboard.
Sir, good afternoon, everyone.
All right. I didn't see you back there. I want to introduce you sooner. I apologize. The Officer Candidate, nuclear-powered officer, ET, used to be an ET-2.
Yes, sir.
And prize candidate out of the 35 of the entire units. Nate gets selected. He's right here at Iowa State University. Alright. So don't drown. Wear your personal flotation device. Motorcycles. Always wear your helmet. Bingo. You play these. Be careful. Alright. Any questions? Is that 5 minutes? It's time.
More like 11.
More like 11.
Okay, piggybacking off the EXO, I'm going to talk about common injuries. So these are your most common injuries that we're probably going to see this summer, which are contusions. What are contusions?
Bruises.
Okay. Concussions, bruises, contusions can also be what?
Cuts.
Okay, good. Lacerations, sprains, and blisters. So prevention, proper personal protective equipment, right? So what are some things that can help you if you're rollerblading? Yes. And how many of you rollerblade? How many of you rollerblade with your dog? Very dangerous.
I don't know.
But I always wear my PPE.
I run with my dog.
Okay, because they're unpredictable. So you always need to wear your PPE, especially when rollerblading. How about if you're biking? Do we have any avid bikers in here going to do the rag bra or anything? Okay, what do you wear? What else?
Sandals.
Okay.
Tight clothing, ma'am.
What's that?
Tight clothing.
Okay.
Well, not for clothing.
What else? What else?
We got a long day.
Reflective belt.
Thank you. Something reflective. You're on the road with cars. Hopefully you're following the direction of traffic. But it is very dangerous out there. People don't like to get over for bicycles. Or sometimes they're texting and they don't see you and they don't look up in time and they could hit you. Okay, everything you can do to make yourself visible, you need to do on a bike. I love Iowa because you guys have so many bike trails here. That's great. Use them. Try to stay off the roads if you can. Okay, and then how about, why did I say anti-friction products up here?
Static resistant, ma'am.
Yes. How many of you, I know a couple of you are training for some long races. What kind of long races do we have this summer?
Marathon.
A marathon.
Ultra.
Who's running a marathon?
Half. Ultra.
Call me out.
Ultraman though.
No, I'm sure.
How about Iron Man?
Love American.
There's a couple Iron Mans. Yep, we have several. Okay, those are long races. Those are races that you're going to be susceptible to getting some of those chafing. Okay, so anti-friction products. Good. Now, the exo mentioned in his last slide, proper foot gear. What shouldn't you be running in this summer?
Flip-flops.
Thank you. Flip-flops. Do not run in flip-flops. That is how you're going to sprain your ankle or break something. Good. Okay, fire safety. So summer is the season of fire. So grilling. How do we properly light a grill?
Yes.
Okay, how do you properly light it? You light the grill, put the lighter fluid on. What do you do?
Turn on the gas, ma'am, and then start it.
Okay.
So with the lid open, ma'am.
Turn on the gas and then put your little igniter on. Good. What else? What if you have charcoal? How many of you charcoal?
That's fine.
Okay. It's cheaper. I know most of you charcoal.
Tastes better.
How do you do it?
Depends on how you
chew it. Put it on the charcoal first and then light it from the sides.
Okay. Do you ever say, oh, it's just not lighting fast enough? I'm going to put some more lighter fluid on there and light it closer. Do not do that. Okay? Do not do that. A good way around that is to buy the charcoal that's self-lighting so that you can probably still need to use a little lighter fluid on it before you light that match. But when you light it, then it will stay. Then you won't have to add that extra lighter fluid. Okay. Alright, so propane. What's the danger of propane?
Explosions.
Yes. Okay. So when you're using when you're grilling with propane, what should you never do?
Turn the gas on and leave it sit there for a while, ma'am.
Good. If you're going to light it, when you turn on that propane, you light it right away. Good. You don't let it build and collect. Anything else?
Check. Always make sure you have the ignition source on, then turn the gas on. That's the gas from building up.
Good. Good. Yes.
Check for leaks, ma'am, on the propane tank.
Always check for leaks. Absolutely. Especially if this is your first time grilling after a long winter. Or am I going to grill in my garage?
No.
Why not?
If you grill up in the propane, it displays oxygen back, you can suffocate.
Good.
Boom.
Okay. What else am I not going to do? Am I going to walk away from my grill for an hour while my chicken cooks?
No,
why not?
Bad chicken,
man. Yes, get a fire. If I know anything about propane grills, they don't cook evenly. It might work good for a year, the next year, they're going to burn your food. You're going to have it on high, you're going to burn everything in there. Campfires. How do you properly start a campfire?
Fire sticks,
ma'am. Consideration. Somebody else?
Paper and kindling, ma'am.
Okay, paper and kindling. What do I want to do before that?
Clear the area around from like dry leaves or make sure there's like dirt on the bottom.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Make a fire ring.
Have a bucket of water safety.
Always have a bucket of water.
Make sure that the area you're in is not in a fire safety warning. So
yes.
In California, if it's super dry, don't be lighting fires because you're not supposed to.
Or anywhere. This weather's crazy. We could be in a drought in a matter of a week.
Don't do it if there's like trees above you.
Good point. Don't do it if there's trees above you, even if those trees are green, right? So we all think we're camping in the woods. We should start a campfire. Look above you. Okay, look above you and see if there campfire rises. Is it going to heat up something and catch fire? Or are the sparks going to fly up and catch the trees on fire? Okay. If you go to the south, what do they have in the south? Do you guys know?
Cotton.
Pine straw.
The trees. They have the leaves. They can go right up. Okay, leaves and debris. Considerations. Think about the wind, what direction it's blowing. If it's blowing at all, you probably shouldn't be burning, right? And then, if there are trees around, and if you're in drought conditions. Fireworks.
I don't have a question, I was just going to share something.
Oh,
there's a guy.
Anybody know who
Jason is?
Is it an NFL football player?
Yep.
It's a guy.
We're pretty disgusting, right?
I asked not to look at the spot button.
Whoops. Okay. So that's his can after a fireworks accident. I just want you guys to really think about that. This is a professional football player, but he was invincible. Okay? He now has his hand half blown off, and actually, he missed half of last season, had to wear a freaking cast or something on his arm for the rest of the season. They don't know if he's coming back this year. He's got to go through more surgeries.
I just have a question quick. Does anybody in their town, do they allow burn barrels?
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. My hometown did, and now they don't because a kid put a perfume can or a spray paint can inside of it and it blew up in his face. Now he's blind. So make sure you're paying attention to that stuff.
There's a guy that was at my high school, and he was like playing with fireworks improperly, and he like blew out his eye, and so now he has like he can't see out of his right eye.
Absolutely, leave the fireworks to professionals. There's absolutely no reason to play with fireworks. They're just too dangerous out there, and they're unpredictable. We don't know who's making the fireworks and what's inside of them once they fire.
Alright. Alright, so good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
So we're going to talk about heat stress real quick, and really heat stress happens is going to happen in the summertime because it's
hot.
There we go, perfect. It's also what?
Humid,
right? Not dry, humid. Humid makes it a lot worse, and we're going to see how much worse it makes it. But you need to be aware of heat stress, okay, when it comes to, there's a lot of stuff with heat illness. There's heat stress, heat exhaustion, heat stroke, heat cramps, heat rash. You know, then there's like exertional heat stress, there's classical heat stroke. I mean, the list goes on and on and on. But I'm going to give you the basic symptoms here so that you can understand what it is, all right, and then what to do when it happens. So pretty much the biggest thing that you're going to realize when anyone is suffering from heat exhaustion, all right, is they're going to be confused, they're going to be irritable, they're going to be in a bad mood, they're going to be wet and clammy, they're going to be weakness, they're going to have sometimes, they're going to stumble. Prime example of a heat stroke, someone had a heat stroke, was, I can't remember his name, but he was running a race, a 10,000 meter race, and he was 200 meters from the finish line, and guess what happened?
Collapsed,
just straight down. And why?
Heat
stroke. He had exertional heat stroke, and his body temperature was 109 degrees.
Jesus.
His brain is cooking. All right. Luckily, he didn't die, okay? Because that is one of the effects of heat stroke is death, because of the fact that there were people there. But yes.
On that note, sir, I was best friends in elementary school with Corey Stringer and his dad, or Corey Stringer's son. His dad was a player for the Vikings. He got heat stroke, and he doesn't have a dad anymore. Dad died out of the accident, so it's serious.
Yeah, this is serious stuff. So, you just gotta pay attention to those symptoms. The biggest one right here, heat stroke, stop sweating. All right, if anyone all of a sudden stops sweating, so the exact opposite of what Stuart was doing during the moto run. if anyone stops sweating, just call 911 right away. And for any of these things, just call 911, get the ambulance there right away. That's really all you can do. Try to cool them down, get them in the shade, get them with some water, all right, so that you can get them to cool down and then they can get where they need to go. All right, so how can you prevent it? Anyone want to take a stab? Just go ahead.
Hydrate, sir.
Yes, hydrate. We're going to talk about that in a minute. Anything else?
Limit your time outside,
yes.
Protect yourself from sun exposure.
Yeah, how can you do that? Anyone else?
Sunscreen.
Well, that's something else. All right, Lloyd Peterson.
Wear outer light clothes, sir.
Wear light clothing, loose fitting, and light color, okay? So not heavy, so don't go growing outside with a hoodie on, okay? I don't know why you would, but people do. You, anyone a wrestler in here? Yeah, you guys were the worst at that stuff. It's like, oh, let me go to the swimming pool and put on 3 layers of sweatpants and sweatshirts and go run 6 miles. I don't know why. But anyways, okay, don't drink alcohol, tea, coffee, or pop. Okay, it's pop, but I put soda for the rest of you. I'm fine. So, but it is pop. All right, why don't you want to drink those? Why?
Because
Caffeine dehydrates you and alcohol dehydrates you. When you actually have a hangover the next day, you actually have a hangover for two reasons. One, because you're dehydrated, and the other one is that alcohol has impurities in the system in it, and then your body is trying to process that, but it can't. So that's why you have that vomiting or that nausea feeling the next day, because you have all those impurities just sitting in your gut. All right, and then avoid workouts and unnecessary exertion. I'm not saying don't work out over the summer. Definitely, please do work out over the summer, but work out indoors in a nice air-conditioned place. Okay, yes, Michelle.
I know, like, where I'm from, a big thing to do in the summer is to, like, go canoeing and drink, and so that's, like, the two things that...
Yeah, Wisconsin.
It's, like, being in the sun, like, over the water, I'm drinking a lot of alcohol, it's all, like, super...
If you're going to be outside drinking alcohol, just... Have a glass, like drink a beer or whatever it is. If you're of age, I'm just putting that out there right now. Have one beer, drink some water, drink a glass of water, and just alternate between the two. Trust me, it'll work. You'll feel great the next day. All right, this is a heat index, okay? All right, how this works is that over here you got the temperature, all right, and then up here you got the humidity, and then it tells you the simulated temperature that you're experiencing. So, oh man, 9 degrees, it's pretty hot, right? We can deal with it. Then we go all the way over here. Oh man, 100% humidity, which can happen on the East Coast or the West Coast.
Look at that.
Yeah, okay, Iowa. 121 degrees simulated. It feels like 121 degrees. Like that is, it's just stupid hot. And you go outside and you're like, this is just stupid. Alright? Or Death Valley. Alright, so these are all the possible heat disorders that can come from it in the areas. Remember, drink water, lots and lots of water, okay? But don't drink too much water because you can't overhydrate. We'll talk about that. So,